Okay, friends, subscribers, and all you YouTubers out there, have I got one for you. Okay, the human anatomy. This is the new world's human anatomy. Okay, let's see where. Where's a better one? We need to get one here. We've got the liver here. I'm trying to find one with the kidneys so that you can see where everything is. I gotta find it. Oh, okay, there's one. There's one. There we go. Renal. Okay, there we go. This is your human anatomy. This is a new earther's human anatomy. Guess what? You're gonna get a big shot, folks. This is what my anatomy used to look like. As soon as I can work out how to do it. Okay. Just gonna pull this in here. Actually, I'm just going to enlarge this up here so it fits in the screen on this one. Okay, there we go. Now, aren't you lucky I'm actually an artist, a master artist to boot. Knows the human anatomy quite well. I've drawn it a few times for people and even a couple of doctors that sort of wanted me to manipulate things so that they could see where different things were, take stuff out of images. So I've drawn this in my reality a few times. I've drawn the human anatomy a few times, okay? Let's start with the rib cage, okay? So, no, let's start with this. Let's start with the features of everything here, okay? Renal system, under the rib cage, wrong. My world, renal system, down here. Kidneys were down here. Under the liver, there. The liver, that's your liver. Massive, massive liver. We had a little liver over here. Our stomach used to be down here. So, hang on. Sorry. I might have that actually back to front. Yeah. The liver's on that side, the stomach's on that side. Hang on. No, that's right. I'm getting too used to watching your friggin' images. No, that stomach is in the right position. The liver is in the right position. The intestines were down here, yes, and the intestines were living with our kidneys. Our renal system, our bladder was down there where it always is. Our kidneys were here, just above our pelvis. Okay, our spinal column, all right, we're going to go back to the spinal column. That's what our spinal column looked like from a frontal view. Okay, came down to the ribs there. We were one missing. Mankind had one missing rib down here. And it was that rib that was missing. The bottom rib that was missing on man. Always behind the liver. I always thought that God made us that way because it was meant to not puncture our liver. But the rib cage there, I've noticed that I haven't made the back of the rib cage low enough as it was. I think I'm down one too high. Here, it should be attached to there. That rib should meet that rib. Okay, so that is a mistake that I've made in the drawing. Okay, I noticed that when I was photocopying it. Now, in the rib cage and everything, now look at your lungs. See where your lungs are here? How they're nice, up high, everything like that. In my reality, we had massive lungs. Our lungs were pretty much the whole size of our rib cage. Our heart was in here. See that little black spot here? That was our spleen. In yours, the spleen is somewhere at the back or somewhere really strange. I'm going to try and find the spleen. Let's have a look. See if we can find the spleen. There's a spleen there. See how the kidneys are right up in your bloody rib cage. They're up there. They're too high. The kidneys should be here. Kidneys should be down here. And your veins seem to be bigger than ours too. It's sort of a bit strange, but yeah. It's sort of just strange. See, the kidneys are just far too high. They're far too high, folks. And it's just the way your thing is. Your heart is pretty much in the same spot as ours. It's not as big, actually. I've noticed that. Your heart's not as big as ours. I thought it was. But doesn't matter what image I go to, you actually have the thing. Now, this is the big change. This is the big change. That is your rib cage. See this here? See how this comes up here to there? You've got this bone here, and it's a bone. You have cartilage. To me, that looks like some giant bug that's wrapped itself around your ribs. And, yeah, so it's quite strange. It's sort of really, really strange. So I'm just going to keep on using this for a sec while I get this one up. This is our rib cage, okay? See this section here, okay? In our rib cage, in my rib cage that I have known and always drawn, our ribs came around into the front. Okay, your cartilage comes out further here, comes out way further. And in my reality, it came into the cartilage. This was nothing but cartilage. This was cartilage. Soft material. And the bones joined the soft material and came down, and it's called the sternum. Don't know what you call it here. And it was cartilage. Every rib bone came into this piece of cartilage. Might have been a little bit thicker, and it's sort of just the way it looks in the thing. It's pretty hard to draw a rib cage and add lungs and everything into it at the same time when you're doing it in one colour. And this is what I call a gestural drawing. In my world, this is called gestural. It's the quickest way. It's not anal retentive like some people draw. It's just to show you a quick layout. But this is what the human rib cage in my world looks like, okay? So if you want to see a different, but guess what? In my reality, it looked like this, but in this reality, the bloody thing looks like this. Yes, I've had an X-ray. But it looks like that. It's different. It's different. You guys have got this bone, and so I've got the X-rays here. I'm going to double check them while we speak. I'm actually going to have a look at them. Now that I've got the rib cage up in front of me, I'm going to actually look at them. You can't actually see this bone here in the X-ray, which is strange. But it's there because it looks more like it's something attached to it, actually. Hey. Because it looks like my sternum's the same, actually. Because guess what? I went and got X-rays. The extra bone is there at the top of the neck. And it's there. The extra bone is actually there. That bone there is actually there in the X-ray. My lungs are smaller, my liver is bigger. My liver looks like someone's fucking head. I'm sorry, I swore, I apologise. I'm sorry, guys. Sorry, ladies, I know. I said I wouldn't swear anymore. I've got a picture here, it looks like a skull inside my head. If there's a creature sitting there, but it's just the liver. Yeah, so, sorry, no, that's the stomach. See, the strange thing is, in your world, we couldn't see these images. Your organs are denser than ours, and I mean denser. They can be seen in X-rays, or you've got different type of X-rays things. And I'm looking at my lung, and my lung looks about as small as your lungs. Very small, very, very small. It's different. It is way different, the way that your bones come off. Now, I noticed something in the X-ray as well at the back of the bones. Now I've got to find one of these here. Sorry, oh bloody hell. Yeah, sorry about that, folks. Getting a bit tired, I've been awake for a while. And let's have a look at this. Front and back of the skeleton. Okay. There is a picture of the skeleton. Sorry for all the X-ray. As you can hear, that's the X-rays in the background. There are similarities. And I can sort of see them, but there are still a couple of changes in those X-rays to what I'm looking at here. But I've noticed with your ribs and things like that, maybe that one should do here. The ribs actually join in a different way. See, our ribs were attached to that vertebrae. They were attached to the vertebrae. And that's what I'm looking for now is pictures of the vertebrae. Here we go. Check it out there. Okay, check this out here. See those little nodules? Can you see them in mine? They come down. They were only there where the ribs were. And then the rest of them was just bang, bang, bang. We had the back bit and tiny, tiny little ones. But if you looked at an x-ray in ours, you didn't see those. You didn't see those in our x-rays. Because they were pretty much behind the back. It sort of, they were attached to that bone. It was quite a small little thing. And they didn't come off the vertebrae. They came, see, the vertebrae came out back, touched that. That was that. That was part of the vertebrae. But the bits that are coming out to the side, these bits, yeah, that's foreign to us. To this, this spinal column is very foreign. Because that's what our spinal column looked like. It had that sort of a format. But it was like that. See, noticing you can't see it. You could see them if you looked at it that way, you would see them because they were tiny little nodules. At the most, you most probably could see that much of them, at the most, because sometimes they did stick out. But in my world, if you had an operation, right, if you had the spinal op on your back, and so the coccyx is different too, and this is different, the sacrum is different to ours, way different. See, these were bones. In ours, our sacrum were still bones. They weren't joined together like this. This is, yours have massed together. Okay, ours were still free. So free that some people, the tail, it was rare. But in our world, our sacrum wasn't solid. Our sacrum was not like this. Our sacrum was still individual bones. Like L5, S1. I had L5 operated on, and I had S1 operated on. But they were separate vertebrae. They were separate vertebrae because I had a disc here that was stuff. We still had discs in this section of our thing. Yours is all fused. Yours is all fused. And these are foreign to us. In my reality, they're foreign. They're too big. Actually, that's most... See that thickness there? That's most probably the thickest you would ever see. But in my reality, when they fused your back, because in your world... Right, they took part of the hip. See that there? They took part of the hip away. Generally, there, or pelvis. They took part of your pelvis away in that section there. And they cut it up and they put it on the side of your spine. On the side of your spine. Now, this is going to spin some people out. I reckon this is a new theory. Okay, this is a new one to my other one. This is a possible theory. What they have done is they've turned around and they've abducted a couple of people that had spinal fusions, and they've taken it as if this is the spine, and because we've got bits cut off here, and on my back they cut these bits off here, and they cut from there, I think it's from there down, they cut that bit off, that bit off, that bit off, that bit off. They were used to make the fusion on one side of my spine, and they were put on the... Oh, no, I had six. That's right. Yeah, because they took three for each. They made one, two, three on the side. Put one, two, three on the side and actually fused it and used that bone glue and fused them to my spine, to this, to the part of the vertebrae. And then what they did is they took those parts of the hip there. Then they made a bone that came down here, came down here. Came down here, came down here, came down here. And that's how they fused my spine together. That's called a laminectomy fusion because they had to remove that disc there and that disc there. In my back, that was where my injury was. And it seems strange too. I have noticed that my S1 doesn't hurt anymore. The one that used to cause me electric shocks doesn't hurt me anymore because it's fused in this reality. I reckon if I went and had a scan, that'd be fused. Because in my reality, that was not fused. Mine were vertebrae. I still had discs. We had discs all the way down to here. The coccyx was the only thing that didn't have a thing. See, in this one, there's no way you could get a residual person having a tail because it was that ability that we still had our vertebrae. Where some people, they could move their coccyx because their muscle. This is how they the tail thing came out of it. Because they had the ability and the muscles, or they've learnt to use their muscles, to move their coccyx. And they were able to bend their coccyx up here just for fun, and they wiggled it like a little tail. And it was just practice. Like, you move any muscle and you can move any part of your bone, but there's no way they could do it with this, because that's solid. In our world, it was down, come down like that. We had discs all the way down to here. That was the disc. That was L5, L4, L3, L1, L2, L3, L4. L5. Actually, yeah, there was a vertebrae there, so that was S5. S5. S5 was between the sacrum and the coccyx. And with me, L5, S1. They were the two discs in my spine that got operated on. And I think they've seen somebody with a fusion, because I'm going back to the possibility we have been abducted. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry to freak you out. We could have been abducted and brought into a world where they've mimicked our whole world, rebuilt a world. And they've been saying that the possibility of building a world is easy. And maybe because there's most probably people more advanced than us out there, this could be a way they could be testing us to show weaknesses and things like that. Well, if they pick blokes like me to build the spinal column off, they got a problem. So, yeah, folks, it's a bit freaky, I know. But you've got to turn around and you've got to think. If they've done that, well, they're in trouble. If they've abducted the weakest of us all, they're definitely up the shit's creek, because if they're looking at me, like, I still might be a tough bastard, but I had to become tough. When you've got an injury like mine, you had to become tough. But, yeah, it's this that's so different. Some people, some of my people reckon it looks like a bug. I'm sorry, New Earthers, it does. It looks like a bug, but I'm not ripping you off. It's just that's been modified. I think they've looked at someone that has had a fusion, and they've thought, well, that must be what they look like, and they've built that as part of the thing. But, see, in our reality, folks, that's our spinal column there. Our rib was the last one you could see. If you looked in an x-ray from here, our rib cage looked like that. It still had the same curve. That's a strange thing. We had these things. These, some of these are very sharp on your world. They weren't sharp. Ours were all rounded like this. Everything was rounded, 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 rounded. These are sharp sort of thing. The clavicle and area is different as well. The shape of your clavicle is way different. The shape of our clavicle was continuous, as with the thing, just thinner bone. They turned into thinner bone. But here, let's go back into this one. I think this is the one I need. Yeah, the clavicle. Yeah, see, so the clavicle here comes here. No, that's not good, because it's not big enough. Something a bit bigger, something a bit bigger, something a bit bigger. Might do that well. That's a bit easier. It's easier to read. Okay, the clavicle. Let's get her up here. Okay, the clavicle. Here, your clavicle comes into the same spot. Oh, you still call it the sternum. That's okay. You still call it the sternum. But our sternum looked like that. It was just pure cartilage. That's all our sternum was pure. Still had to be cut with a saw, but it was pure cartilage. It was solid. It was a hard cartilage. It wasn't bone, but it was a hard cartilage. The clavicle here comes to the top of the sternum, right? Comes to the top of the sternum, the same, but it came to the cartilage. It was cartilage in our worlds. You still have cartilage, but you have a sternum bone, not a sternum cartilage. Ours was sternum was made of pure cartilage. And it was solid. Yeah, it was hard. But it was most probably the toughest cartilage we had in our body. Something that never wore out. It was there. It was meant to protect our heart. You guys look like you've perfected it, but you've added an extra bone here. See, we had that bone here, there, is still there. Maybe you don't have an extra one. Maybe you just have a different setup. They're a bit wider than ours. Ours weren't so wide apart. Ours were pretty close together. Because if you broke a rib, man, you could punch your lung. That's everything. You always protected your rib cage because you didn't want to wreck your rib cage. Because if you punch your lung, that's what I said in that picture the other day of that guy with the big hole in his chest where he would have been dead down here if he got a hole in his chest. Because that's generally, if you got a lung puncture down in this area, it was one of the few places you was pretty much fatal. Up higher, you pretty much could get away with it a little bit. But there were a few important factors in the lower part of our lung for some reason. I can't remember the exact reason. But our lung, that is our lung there, comes around here. Follow the arrow, down here, up there, up there, in there. The spleen was tucked in here. That was our spleen inside the middle of our rib cage. Our esophagus came down right between the two into our stomach down here. Because if you had a duodenum ulcer, you put your hand down in this area here, and your duodenum was here, and the shit would come through and everything. And I reckon it could be the cause why my reflux has gotten worse too, because the stomach is shifted and not as well protected as what it used to be. It's sort of, because they said I've got a fuck bowel. I'm wondering if it's been a I'm wondering if I've dimension jumped before and it's been the dimension jumping that's causing the shit. But yeah, our rib cage pretty much took up by the lungs. They were protected. That was the whole purpose of our. They were considered in our world the most vital organs, and in our world because they were considered the most vital organs because they were the only things that the rib cage protected. Our kidneys weren't protected like yours are. Our rib cage is way different, and the liver, yeah, the liver actually is in the right spot, the stomach is in the right spot, the duodenum is those little balls that I drew there, and then it went into the large intestine, and then into the small intestine, but that was our kidney section, that was our kidneys down here, so those of you from the old earth will remember this, and yes, you can say thanks for the drawing, just a joke, but yeah, we did not have this here, this bone here that you've actually named. We had the bones, we had the tibula, the fibula, we had all these, capitis, fibulus, but we didn't have those holes. Sorry, we did not have those holes. And our sacrum is, the sacrum is actually in a different spot. Yeah, the sacrum should be down lower. Yeah, the sacrum should be way lower than that. Yeah, actually that's something I've just noticed. The sacrum, yeah, that is, even in that one. The sacrum's too high. Yeah, it should be lower. It should be lower. It should be lower. It should be down here. It should be way down there. Yeah. So, yeah, either we've been abducted and they've tried to copy someone like me that's had major spinal injury and they've made a fuck-up. See, that rib cage is too small for us. Yeah, that is way too small. Our rib cage was bigger than that. It sort of... That was would have been one of the full. That would have been a full bone in our rib cage. It came around. So to me, that looks like a chimpanzee's rib cage. Is what it looks like. No offense, guys. It does. It looks like a chimp rib cage. As if they've pieced us together and they're trying to make us think. See, that is the possibility. They could be making us think. Oh, here's another one. We're clones that have been modified. Okay, that's another reality. And they haven't had too much, didn't expect the memory to come across, most probably. We could be the product of this alien building better people and replacing us, and they fucked up because we've all remembered everything. And I just hope they're not making any more. Or we were abducted. And this is another possibility. This could be a bug of some description. That sternum there could actually be a bug. Someone has said to me, it's a bug. It looks like a bug. It's got its arms wrapped around. And I've even said that before. But, see, with us, yes, we had cartilage. Your cartilage goes a lot further than ours did. A lot further than ours. Because ours come right up here and joined in here, as I showed you. And, yeah, that is old Earth. Well, for this thing... I don't know if there are minor changes. Please tell me what the change to your rib cage was, because, and if that is right to you. If you're an old earther, your kidneys and everything should be down here. If you're from my reality, anyhow, that's where your kidneys are, is there. There. Liver there. Stomach there. Intestines here. Spleen here in the middle of the heart. How do I know the spleen's there? Because one of my mates had a spleen operation. I don't know where they cut him. And so, yeah, folks, it's you've got to turn around and you've got to look at everything. And it was quite common for people to have a heart operation in mine, and they just cut straight through the sternum, opened you up, put it back. And the reason why they were able to cut through the sternum and everything, because it healed. Because it was a type of cartilage that healed. And they were able to stitch it together and put it back together. But the lungs, your lungs are far too small. And yet they're in there. My x-rays is being that small, whether or not they've thrown in the thing. And strange thing is, about 6 weeks back, my doctor told me I had an enlarged liver. I think she's from a different reality as me. But, yeah, it's the changes to the spinal column that are freaking me out a bit. Because that looks like my, as I said, looks like the bones that are coming off mine that they've turned around and modified and turned into my spinal fusion. In my world, laminectomy fusion. But in our world, this kept on coming. That was a vertebrae? Yes. No, that wasn't a vertebrae. Actually, I've just noticed that. Wow, that wasn't a vertebrae. Let me have a look. Let's go in here. Yeah, that's something else that's different. That was solid bone. The pelvis? Yeah. The pelvis was all solid. And it was joined by one vertebrae. It came through by one vertebrae. But yours is all fused. Yours, what's this? Okay, we don't have that. We never had that. And it's a little bit smaller too. The shape of your pelvis is different. It's sort of, this could be a woman. Sorry, that could be a woman's pelvis. But so there are changes to your world. Definite changes that I've just noticed then that I didn't notice before. I'm still going through this. I am still learning. What the hell is that? Bone anatomy. Okay, that's a bit different to my world. Marrow bone, but the rib cage, that is so different. There's the rib cage there. That's a different rib cage. As if that's a bug. And this is why some people said it looks like a bug wrapped around that's got its. It's mimicking the rib cage and it's wrapping around. Like we have that rib there. There it is, that rib there. We have that rib. That's the last rib. But in this one, there's another one that comes around here. We don't have that, see? We don't have that one that goes around there. And that's the other rib that's the missing rib. See, ours came, and this coming up like that, ours came in up a little bit into the thing and everything. Where these are attached up here, they're too high. Your clavicles are way too high. Our clavicles came down here. They were on an angle like this. That was our clavicle. And yeah, I know my spelling's a bit wrong in my picture, but it was in my picture. It was just me roughly drawing. So, and I hate these things sometimes. It pisses me off. And your rib cage is totally different, folks. It's really, really spun out to me, and it looks as if it's similar. It's very similar, very, very similar. You're missing that little tit up the top. See how it tips in up the top, upwards, 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 upwards. That's the way our spine was. And that's the way our clavicle was. It's the way our sternum was. Different. Way different. This bone to us is foreign. You have an extra bone. The clavicle should be touching here. Clavicle was a V. It was always a V. And in this, little V, not much. And I've actually been out and I had a look at a few skeletons, and I can tell you now they look so fucking weird to me. The sternum is so different. And, the sternum's different. It's really, really strange. That actually looks like it's an old human's thing. That's different to us. That's way different, folks. That is not to us, the human. Okay, there we go. Oh, you still have the extra rib. You do have the extra male rib. There it is, folks. See, anybody says they don't have the extra rib, there it is there. There's the extra rib. They do have the extra rib. So, someone said they didn't have it. But I didn't notice that. So, yeah, small part of the bone. No, they've got a whole... It looks like they've only taken part of the rib. Took the whole rib in my reality. So, you've got to turn around. You've got to look at these differences, folks. Look at this. And anybody from my world, look at that. That's just so fucking spun out. To me, there are major differences in everything. And I'm finding more. Every single time I come along, I'm finding more of these. More of these. And sort of... But it's the way, like, shoulder blades are different and everything like that. And sort of, your pelvises are different. Your skull is different. Your muscular structure, actually, yeah. You know, the muscular structure, that's a wee bit different to ours. That's a wee bit different. Yeah, it's sort of the way the everything wraps around here, wraps around there. We had more muscles coming down here. These muscles here on the outside were more on the outside. Because when you scrunch your neck, they used to show up and come down. And they'd emphasize in the skin even, and sort of you could see them. Bodybuilders used to love flexing them, sort of in my world. But this, the sacral sutures is really fucking weird. And I'm sorry, I apologize, ladies. I've sworn again, I apologize. Okay, I'm watching, see, I am listening to your comments. And but I'm noticing these t-shirts, they're friggin' everywhere in this world. We didn't have as many rib t-shirts. Why did we want pictures of our ribs on our ribs? It's sort of really, really, really weird. It's sort of, see, they're everywhere, pictures of the rib cage. It's sort of like the only time we ever, hey, actually, this could be a possible explanation for these shirts. They've come down here at Halloween and they've seen our Halloween costumes. Because the only time we ever had this on a shirt was at Halloween. And I'd say they've been watching TV. And this is an attempt to mimic us. And it is. This is actually a very big possibility, folks. This could be the real reason to what has happened. And they're trying to mimic us. And they've had limited information. And this is their attempt to mimic us. They could have replaced our whole families. So, yeah, we don't know what it's about. They've seen Halloween costumes, I'd say. They have seen how... That could be the perfect explanation why there's so many T-shirts like this. They've seen our Halloween costumes. And they've taken it that we wear these all the time. They've seen a Halloween... Because, okay, skulls? Yeah, we wear skulls all the time. But, yeah, there's too many major changes. And as I said, like with the spinal column, I reckon they've abducted a few people with sacral fusions. Not sacral fusions. Laminectomy fusions. Oh, it'd be a heartburn. Yeah, I notice I'll get a lot of that in this world. And, okay, well, they've still got osteoporosis. But these are different. These are way different. But the rib cage, yeah, no, they don't have the extra bone. No, I don't know, it might have been someone with an injury. But this, the only time you saw that is if someone had an operated laminectomy fusion. That's what I'm saying, yeah. And it looks like they're mimicking the laminectomy fusion here. But that's too short. That's too short. There were extra bone. There was extra bone. Or it could just be because theirs is fused, ours is not. And that's what it's... Yeah, that's a possible explanation, folks. They've taken someone, or taken a few people, because a lot of people have had that operation here. In my reality, it's a pretty common operation in my world. And they've looked at Halloween. They've abducted people with Halloween or watched our TV shows and they've seen that people wear ribs on their clothing. They wear bones on their clothing. The only time we wore bones on our clothing... was at Halloween. In my reality, it was the only time we wore skeleton. Or a party. We went out to a party, fancy dress. Maybe they have been abducting us. Because that still remains a very great possibility. Yeah? could be thing. And the strange thing is, I got some footage from the plane that actually looks different. I actually noticed it. And I just, I'm one of these blokes that holds the camera up and records the whole flight just in case Arthur goes down. So they've got a recording of what happened. And I hold it out the window unless something happens. And I noticed something strange. All the way down the coast, there was like this big cloud all really high around the coast. It was strange as. So I recorded it. And, and the strange thing is all my x-rays look different. All my x-rays look different. Look like they've been doctored. I'm going to, if I can work out a way of scanning it in, I'm going to show you all. Because it's so different, folks. It's sort of, but that's a good explanation why they wear it on their t-shirts and bones on their t-shirts. See? Now this one. In my world, they would fucking well wear a shirt like him and an anatomy skeleton foot bone on the thing. On bags. Everything like that. See, I'm going to say we've been abducted. Okay, they've watched too many fucking Halloween movies or too many Bart Simpson fucking movies on TV or whatever, and they've seen that people wear bones on their clothing and assume that we wear bones on our clothing all the time. Well, we don't. We only ever did that on Halloween. One day a year. One fucking day a year. Well, maybe, okay, here's another explanation. Maybe this is demons from Halloween trying to fuck us over. But I've got to look at it from the funny point of view, folks. I've got to do something. I've lost three fucking children, so it's sort of... I've got to try and make this reality work for me, and I'm coping with it the best way I can, and I just realised I swore again, ladies. I'm sorry. Yeah, so... but this... I love that, how it fits over the titties. It'd be a good tattoo. Yeah, ladies, yes, I'm still a male. Okay, I'm still a male. But yeah, those ribs are in the wrong spot. They look like a chimpanzee rib. And the most probably thinking, okay, well, think maybe this is how they designed us. It's sort of, in this world, they pinched it. Well, they did evolve from, in our world, it was theory. In this world, it might be a reality. But so there's multiple things that you can think of. I don't know what's going on, folks. I really don't know. All I know is it's happened. It's freaking the shit out of me. It really is. Trust me, I'm a tough nut, and I'm freaked out. Something's shocking. And I want to go home. I do. I just want to go home to my kids. I want to hold them and hug them. Tell them I love them. Tell them they've got to meet their brothers and sisters finally. And sort of no more of this shit. Like, oh, I don't want to come down. I can't make it. All this crap. Okay, they've got different mothers in my world, and it was been a nightmare for me, always trying to get them together, and it has. But after this, if I get home, I can tell you now, they're going to have no choice in the matter. If I have to lie to them to get them together, I'm going to do it, because they're going to meet each other, and they're going to have each other in case something like this ever happens again. They're going to know their family. And in my world, yeah, we got a bit of a problem with divorce and things like that, and we got a few blokes that were like me, that were root rats and just spread the seed around a bit too much. And guess what? They caught up with me and all tracked me down. Yeah, all took money off me. But they did, yeah. They stuck me for a few quid. And because I was a root rat, I didn't care. I didn't wear protection. And that's how I wound up with five children with five different mothers. It was something. It was a bragging tool, sort of, with my mates and... I tried to, it was a bit ashamed of it with women, but the thing is, it's a mistake I made when I was younger. I ran a nightclub, I had a bit of freedom. My eldest was born when I was 15. I was dating an 18-year-old. I thought it was great until Mum found out, and unfortunately poor girl got threatened with carnal knowledge and ran, and because she didn't know. I told her I was 18, and she didn't know I was only 15. She freaked out, and I never saw her for many years, and I think I was about 17, 18 when I found out I was the father, and I had minimal contact at first, then I had a good contact period, and then I had none at all as she was going through her teens. I've been through that with all my children when they went through their teens. I don't know what it is about teenage years. I hope it's not the same for you guys here. It can be a nightmare, teenage years. But I've had good relationships with them over the years, except for one. She's still indoctrinated in the religion. Even in this reality, she's indoctrinated to that same religion. I'm not going to mention the religion, but those of you that might have had the problems might guess what one it is. But the thing is, it's, yeah, a nightmare. And it is a nightmare, folks. I'm coping. I'm coping because I'm a traveller, and I'm talking to you guys, and I'm talking about it. And in death and everything like that, it's the same thing. You need to talk about it. I've lost my children, as far as I'm concerned. They just don't exist. They never existed. No, I don't have photos, guys. Please stop asking me, did I have photos? I did have plenty of photos at home. I don't have them here in this reality. Because they just didn't exist. They did not exist in this reality. Oh, no, sorry. He didn't take photos. And notice I said he. I'm actually looking after his stuff most probably better than he left it. It's getting cleaner here than it was. He wasn't as clean as me. But I wasn't clean. I said I was organized. I was organized disaster, I called it, in my reality. But here, this guy just didn't give a shit. He'd done his work, and you can see the art pieces he puts on. It's strange. This guy, the art in this house is the best protected thing in this house. Everything else, his tools, everything else is just everywhere, strewn everywhere. It's sort of, I'm cleaning it up slowly. But the thing is, it's sort of, I was always organized chaos. I had everything in boxes, and I'm putting everything in boxes. His poor bugger's not going to know what happened. I'm going to put a little note for him just in case, and I've actually already thought of what I'm going to say, and I'm just going to have it lying there just in case he does come home or to the next person that comes into this reality. And I'm actually going to leave my note, because we live here on our own, or hopefully if they don't, unless they're married, so that could be a problem. But in this reality, it's sort of, if he comes here, well, he's going to know what the hell's going on. He's going to know where everything is. I've left him little hints on what to do here to there, what's going on. I've even told him about the Mandela thing already. I've left him that. I've told him about something that he can't help but to notice and everything. Oh, I'm still working on the film set. It looks like he's a little bit more behind than I was on my film set. Most probably about 6 months behind to what I had built in the film set, because I was building a film set here, and he is too. He's got similar sort of computers, some are different, one's way bigger than mine, and pretty good computer too, actually. It's not for the net, it's for something, it's for the film. But yeah, he's bought similar stuff, but yeah, organized chaos. I had to go and buy alcohol, because unlike him, unlike me, he's still is packed away behind a box, not being used, where mine was always in full production. So I've had to go out and buy alcohol until I can dig it out. And sort of, it was in my reality, it was there for about 2 months while I was getting some work done, but I pulled it out and set it all up. My whole kitchen was a brewer. And in here, it's not as good, sort of finding stuff and getting stuff out and finding stuff in a mess. And so I've got to make changes here, and you're going to find that. And some of you most probably always found that. Yeah, is that better? Oh, wow. Sorry about that, folks. I just noticed the sound went off. I accidentally clicked off the sound. So there's a bit of things I was talking about me. So, yeah, don't worry about it. But, yeah, not important. Yeah, I just went off on a tangent, so it's okay. I accidentally clicked the off button. But, yeah, sorry about that, folks. And I apologize to all the ladies and girls for filming. But, yeah, life has changed. Embrace the reality we are in. Embrace the people around you. Love them as much as you did in your old reality. Help them out. We don't know whether or not we have been abducted, and these are we're clones. And that is a major possibility, that we're clones of our old former self. And this has just been made to look like us, everything around us, so that we don't jump. I still believe we have jumped realities. There's too many differences in the globe that make it so that we don't know what's going on. So yeah, it's up to yourselves, guys. Just do your best, cope. That's all we can do temporarily. If anybody does find anything out about how this happened, for God's sake, tell us. Don't. I've got one bloke saying this and one bloke saying that. I even get home, I found out they're just taking the piss out of us. They just say he doesn't say it anymore because he can't get in it anymore. But the thing is, it's sort of, yeah, things have changed. Nothing we can do about it, if we can. But what we can do is, once the Mandela Society is up and running and we have formed it, we have membership and everything, it's going to still take a bit of time because I'm only working. I've only got, especially now that I'm going back to college, because I'm going to continue my college because he was doing the same course as I was. There are a few differences to it, but those differences actually are good for me because I didn't like doing them in my reality anyhow. So a couple of the subjects are different. And yeah, so just keep up the what you've got, hold fast, embrace the ones and love the ones around you. And if you've got kids in this reality, some of the people have had their kids come, oh, check this out. Yeah, I was actually walking up through the mall today. I had to go up and buy something, mainly the Bible. And I decided I'll nick up and get something else. I wanted to get a new pair of reading glasses. So I went up and to get the reading glasses and everything. And on the way up there, I heard a couple of kids talking. And these kids are like 13 and 14-year-olds talking to their dad. And I think their mum's disappeared from the reality or something, or they've got a different mum, or like they're divorced. I don't know what the story was. And the two girls were talking, oh, if we get back to our reality, the reunion with mum is going to be so grand. And my heart melted. And I actually followed them for a bit further than I should have, but I was listening to the conversation, and they were talking about their mum. And they were talking about the Mandela effect. So it's not everybody on the internet, darlings, and everything, and you got to turn around, and if you're out there listening to this, I'm sorry that I listened to your conversation, but I hope you find your mum, darling, because I've lost a couple of kids, and I've got two kids here now, and so it's strange, I know, so just hold fast to what you got, and everything will be fine. Anyhow, I love yous all. I'll see you in the next video. So, but I wanted to share that skeleton with you, and that's what the human anatomy looked like in my world, and I'm going to bring it up one last time. That is my reality. That is my skeleton. That is my liver. That is my stomach. That is where my kidneys used to be. And trust me, I'm saying used to be, because guess what? In my reality, my lungs, everything are smaller. My liver is larger. And it's really, really weird. So the bodies have changed. Whether or not it's our souls that have merged realities, whether or not it's just our consciousness has come across, whether or not we have been abducted or just clones of our former selves, something has happened. But that's what I used to look like inside. That was me. And that's what freaks me about the human anatomy, when people say the human anatomy has changed. Those of you that are old earthers are going to love this video. I'm expecting all your comments. New earthers, if you don't like what we used to look like, well, tough. If you ridicule the people in this channel for saying something, I'm going to block yous, and I'm going to warn yous again. Anybody, any trolls come in here, you're going to be blocked pretty quick, because I monitor the comments. Your comments will show up for a short period of time or just simply disappear. And if I don't like what you're doing to people in this channel, you're going to go. And I will bar you from the channel. So anyhow, guys, look after yourselves. I love yous all. I'll see yous there. I'm still working on the Mandela Society. And the quicker I can get it up, the better, I know. And but it is there. And the link is in the last video, the last couple of videos that I've done. So anyhow, guys, have a good time. I'll see you later. And embrace everything around you. Learn about this world. To me, it's a really cool experience going up the break wall and looking at the beach and looking how the ships are coming in. It's so freaky, but I'm enjoying it. It's sort of like, it's upsetting that it's different. But yeah, we're going to do our best. And once the society's up and running, we can lobby the governments to do something about CERN, to stop all activity at CERN until such time that they can prove to that they're not the cause of this problem, and or that they can fix the problem or whatever. But let's just say it's got to be shut down. So we've got to make that our goal, and that is to shut down CERN in a good way. We're going to do it legally. We're going to lobby the governments and lobby the UN. And if you're any good at writing letters and lobby letters or anything like that, because there's got to be one or two pollies out there that have been affected by this. Yeah, let me know. Contact me, and because we're going to need some lobbyists as well, because we're gonna stop this from happening, and we're going to lobby the governments to go overseas and do something about it, because they've got to start. By now, they're realising, because too many people are ringing up, and I've had people tell me they're running the government and ask them what the fuck is going on, why are they changing maps and getting hung up on, but they're going to have to start accepting it, because they're aware of our videos, trust me. My videos take a long while to upload now, very strangely take a long while to upload. So, and I'm even using Snagit, and Snagit's an easy one to do it. And, but anyhow, guys, it's starting to get a bit cold here and everything, so I'm going to catch us later. Getting a bit late, I've got tech tomorrow. Oh, shit. Okay, I've had another time shift. It's now 51 minutes 48 seconds into the video. I was recording at 9 p.m. so it should only be 10 p.m. The time should only be 10 p.m. folks, and it's now 3:17 in the morning. It's happened again. It seems to be happening at night. As I said, those of us that I think are not being affected by these shifts are the ones asleep. Yeah, I think there's something to it. My dogs are going nuts too for some unknown reason at 4 a.m. in the morning. So, okay, folks, look, stick with it. Get it there. And yeah, love is all. I'll catch you later. 52 minutes in the video. We've had, that means it's a 6 hour time jump. How's that? Same time jump as before. I've turned around, I've looked at the clock, and I think to myself, oh, it must be getting near bloody 11 o'clock. I might go to bed and have an early night, because I've got TAFE tomorrow. I'm definitely going to bed, so I'm not even going to upload these tonight. I'll be uploading them tomorrow, because I've got to go to TAFE in about 3 hours, 3-4 hours. So another time, missing time has just happened, folks. I started this one at 9 p.m. and it is now 3:18 a.m. in the morning. Oh no, this one's about 5 hours. Oh, hang on, no. Okay, no. I started this by that clock at 9 p.m. so that clock at 9 p.m. would have been 8 o'clock. Okay, sorry, it's set at daylight savings time. So yeah, it's a 6 hour missing time again. 6 hours missing time. Okay, I'm not as excited as last time. It's already happened to me once. It's now 3:19 a.m. It's now, 3:19 a.m. And it's most probably, it was about 8 o'clock when I started the video. It was 9 o'clock by that clock because it's set at daylight savings. That is generally the clock I look at, because that way I can never be late, because I'm always an hour ahead. And that's one of the reasons why I leave it there. But it does get a bit confusing sometimes, like now. But yes, another time slip has happened, and it's at a different time of night. So this is quite weird. It's happened again. And yeah, I know the guy out there that said, I should have a timestamp on the video. I don't have a timestamp on the video, okay? But I'm looking at the clock, and I've got no way of moving the bloody screen. It's 54 minutes into the video this time when it has happened. But it could have happened any time throughout this video, and I've just turned around and thinking, okay, it's time to go to bed, and it's now bloody 3:20 a.m. in the morning. So it's happened again. All right, no worries. See you later. Love you all. I'm spun out again, but I'm not as excited because I'm too tired, and I've got to go to bed, and I've got to get up in TAFE in the morning, so I'm sorry. See you later. Bye.